Challenge is going to be to find some fresh water. So I'm going to head up this trail, up in here. I'm going to cross over the island to the other side, and I'm going to try and find some water before this becomes a survival documentary.
So I can hear the sea just up ahead, so it can't be far off now. So we've arrived at the far side of the island, and try and find some fresh water. So I have had a slight issue with my water source.
Not good.
Second water source. Also a no-go.
Time out.
Day two on the island. Just packing my bag now, getting ready to leave. Won't have to carry as much stuff today, so I'll be a wee bit lighter. So hopefully I can cover a bit more distance and explore a bit more of the island. See these prints here, which are obviously from wolves.
These must have been left either last night or this morning.
Gonna walk around and try and work out what direction they're going in. So the track from the beach lead up through here. But yeah, unfortunately I'm not gonna be able to get along this path. But we can head around the outside, see if we can pick up any tracks on any of the other beaches.
I was just walking along the beach there and saw a lot of plovers and sandpipers gathering at the surface. So I went up to have a look and yeah, third time lucky. And just an eagle casually swooping overhead.
Some running up here, there's another set just running along here. yeah, plenty of activity. So I think tomorrow I'm going to aim to come back here very early in the morning. And you never know, we'll see what happens. Just about to get going, and I'm very keen to get going because I am freezing. Yeah, looks nice. So the bay where I found the wolf tracks, it's just around this corner up here. I'm here nice and early, you can hear the film, it's just starting to come up from behind those trees. I'm hoping that if I sit up there long enough, I might still have a chance of seeing one. So I'm pulled up in here, just kind of waiting and hoping that something might come past. So yeah, we'll see. So I've been sitting here for just over 2 hours and I've seen 3 ravens, 1 bald eagle. Unfortunately I couldn't get a picture of the bald eagle because somebody put all these trees in the way. On the bright side, it looks like there was a glorious sunset. Obviously that was behind me. So just up in this tree. What? They just scared off of bald eagles. So I was just sitting up there. Remember the plane came in and scared off the eagles. And I followed them across the bay and they should be up in this big tree here. So I'm going to walk along and hopefully we can get there before they fly off again. We'll see. So third time lucky. Just up in this tree up here. 2 bald eagles. It might seem weird to see 2 in the same tree, but this will be a male and a female, there'll be a pair, and they'll probably at this time of year have a nest somewhere down this beach and they'll be trying to raise a chick. So over the last few days, I've seen lots of whale watching boats come into and out of this bay. So I figured tonight, I'll put my feet up and see if I could see any for myself. Ooh, got one. Chill here, maybe get the legs up or something, I guess.
whale watching. Not very comfortable at all, actually.
Set an alarm for slightly earlier this morning. Only problem is it's absolutely freezing. It's really hard to get out of this sleeping bag at the minute. We'll do our best.
I'm just over there making breakfast and I spotted some tracks, so I thought I'd follow them back to see where they came to. So we've got some tracks just here for you. So he's come along here and stopped here. Now what made him stop here was probably the fact that that's my tent right there. Wolf tracks, tent. I slept through the whole thing like a baby. I didn't even notice.
Just come round the corner and there is a wolf literally sitting over there. Look. Possibly the coolest thing I've ever seen in my life. That was awesome. My heart is going.